In people's minds, deserts are regarded as one of the most terrible enemies in nature. But you can't believe that in China's largest desert area, a vast dreamlike wheat field has been successfully planted. People generally believe that wheat can only grow in fertile soil, is not adapted to sandy or heavy clay soil, and cannot withstand long-term high temperature, dryness, or severe cold. But in 2023, Chinese agronomists, with the help of technological innovation, developed a set of water and fertilizer management and cultivation models adapted to the desert environment. This innovative technology was first applied to wheat field planting in the Taklimakan Desert. After half a year of hard work, these wheats not only successfully withstood all kinds of harsh conditions, but also thrived miraculously. This vast sandy land was covered with a piece of dreamlike wheat field, which was an incredible sight. Now, these mature wheats are now ushering in the harvest period. China's large harvesters are busy shuttling through the wheat fields and successfully harvested 3,000 tons of high-quality wheat. But this achievement is thought-provoking. How did China grow wheat in the desert? China obviously has a lot of fertile arable land. Why did it choose to challenge wheat planting in such an environment? If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. In fact, growing crops in the desert is of great significance. This practice can change the original appearance of the desert, increase the diversity of the ecosystem, and improve the water and carbon storage capacity of the land. Most importantly, growing crops in the desert can also bring considerable economic benefits, thereby improving the living conditions of local residents. In particular, China is one of the countries with more deserts. If the Gobi Desert is included, its area reaches 1.28 million square kilometers, accounting for 13% of the country's total land area. Among them, the Taklimakan Desert has reached 330,000 square kilometers, which is almost equivalent to the land area of Italy. In the past nearly 70 years, China has been working hard to prevent and control sand. From the initial grid sand control to the modern advanced photovoltaic sand control, millions of people have successfully completed the sand control task of 20.33 million hectares after years of hard work, achieving a historic transformation from sand advancing and people retreating to green advancing and sand retreating. In today's China, many deserts have transformed from the former barren land to oasis on the frontier. And these changes have also laid a solid foundation for China to develop agriculture in the desert. As a common food crop in northern China, wheat has now become one of the options for planting in the desert. However, Megadi County, which nourishes this wheat field, is surrounded by sand on three sides, and its desert area accounts for 90% of the total area of the county. The county has 460,000 mu of light saline alkali land, and 150,000 mu of heavy saline alkali land. Planting wheat in such a desert environment sounds like a fairy tale. But it took China just over half a year to successfully turn the fairy tale into reality. They explored a way to control sand and return to farming in the desert. So how did they do it? In order to sow wheat smoothly, Chinese agricultural experts spent 2 months carefully treating the desert surface and flattening it to a fine sand flatland with a height difference of no more than 5 centimeters. Especially in the Taklimakan Desert, facing extreme environmental challenges, the team must plant vegetation immediately after the land is leveled. If delayed, even a sandstorm may quickly restore the land to its original state. However, traditional planting techniques are obviously not suitable for the harsh conditions here. The soil in the desert lacks organic matter and nutrients, water evaporates quickly, and the soil has poor water and fertilizer retention capacity. Faced with these difficulties, wheat is difficult to survive in the desert. In response to these problems, Chinese agronomists have developed a set of water and fertilizer management and cultivation models suitable for desert environments to ensure that wheat seedlings can grow healthily and gradually turn the desert into fertile land and oasis. In October 2023, more than 6,000 acres of winter wheat seeds were sown into the soil. During this experimental planting process, Chinese agronomists regularly visited wheat fields, measured soil data, and observed the growth of wheat. They constantly adjusted irrigation and fertilization strategies and optimized these plans based on wheat growth data. After more than half a year of field operations, they successfully developed a set of replicable and popularizable desert wheat water and fertilizer integrated planting technology. In order to ensure that winter wheat can survive in the desert environment, Chinese agronomists have also increased the use of organic matter and sand fixation and water retention agents, sprayed plant antibacterial agents, and adopted water and fertilizer integration technology, which greatly improved the efficiency of water and fertilizer utilization. Interestingly, these processes can be controlled by mobile phone app to achieve timed and quantitative fertilization, greatly reduce labor input, save more than 35% of water resources, and reduce fertilizer use by 30%, so as to achieve the goal of saving costs and increasing efficiency and improving crop quality and yield. In just half a year, this batch of wheat seeds has gone through a series of difficult tests such as germination, wintering, resistance to wind and sand, drought resistance, and resistance to dry hot winds. Fortunately, most of these wheats survived successfully. In June 2024, this batch of winter wheat planted in the desert will be harvested for the first time. The final yield measurement results are also incredible. The bulk density of wheat reached 825 grams per liter, reaching the standard of first-grade wheat, and its yield per mu exceeded 260 kilograms. Now, Chinese agronomists are committed to summarizing experience and scientific management, striving to develop a set of desert wheat planting technology system that is easy to promote. Their goal is to increase wheat yields to 400 kilograms per mu, and they plan to expand the planting area of desert wheat fields to 50,000 mu in the next 5 years. This whole process not only demonstrates the progress of China's agricultural technology, but also brings new possibilities for agricultural development and ecological environment governance in desert areas. In fact, many countries around the world are also facing the challenge of desertification, and Saudi Arabia is one of them. Saudi Arabia, a famous oil power, is world famous for its prosperous economy and oil resources. But in addition to oil, there are vast deserts hidden in Saudi Arabia's vast territory. As far as I know, Saudi Arabia has a land area of about 2.25 million square kilometers, of which up to 860,000 square kilometers are desert areas. In its north, the Great Nefud Desert extends, while the south is covered by the Rub Al-Khali Desert, making Saudi Arabia the second largest country in the world in terms of desert area. Due to this geographical feature, most of Saudi Arabia has a subtropical desert climate, except for the Western Plateau area, which enjoys a Mediterranean climate. Under such climatic conditions, the highest temperature in summer can even exceed the limit of 50 degrees Celsius, while the average annual rainfall is less than 200 millimeters. These extreme natural conditions have led to a large amount of semi-arid wasteland and low-grade grassland in Saudi Arabia, accounting for 70% of the total land area. At the same time, the arable land area is about 3.44 million hectares, accounting for only 1.5% of the total land area. Permanent grassland is slightly more, accounting for 1.9%, about 3.785 million hectares. Woodland is even scarcer, with less than 0.5% of the land covered by trees. As early as the early 1960s, Saudi Arabia's annual wheat production was only 3,000 tons, but it rose to 4 million tons in the 1980s. In the 1990s, Saudi Arabia even became the world's sixth largest grain exporter, But Saudi Arabia's agriculture was like a flash in the pan, and it declined in just 20 years. Entering the 21st century, Saudi Arabia's food once again relied on imports, and the myth of turning deserts into fertile fields in the Middle East was shattered. The reason is simple. Saudi Arabia's groundwater resources are being used less and less, and environmental damage is coming along with it. In order to keep crops growing well, fertilizers are often overused, causing serious soil degradation, which seems to be a loss. In order to stimulate the development of local agriculture, the Saudi government began to distribute a large amount of land to individuals free of charge. As long as more than a quarter of the land can be reclaimed, the land can be permanently owned. In addition, Saudi Arabia has a plan that as long as someone can successfully grow food, the government will purchase it at several times the market price. It sounds like being a farmer in Saudi Arabia is a sure thing. So many people have joined the army of agricultural development. Against this background, China's desert wheat planting technology is particularly important to Saudi Arabia. As one of the first countries to respond to China's Belt and Road initiative, Saudi Arabia is considering introducing a revolutionary agricultural technology. If it can be successfully applied to Saudi Arabia's vast desert areas in the future, it is expected to greatly improve the local environment. By planting wheat, it can not only increase vegetation coverage and reduce wind and sand invasion, but also stabilize the flowing sand dunes and effectively prevent the further spread of desertification. In addition, the penetration of wheat roots can also help increase the organic matter content in the soil and improve the soil structure, thereby enhancing the water retention and fertility of the soil. The benefits of growing wheat are far more than just improving the geographical environment. This activity is also expected to greatly promote Saudi Arabia's economic development, drive the prosperity of related industrial chains such as agriculture, processing, and sales, and inject new vitality into the Saudi economy. It can be imagined that by transforming the vast desert into fertile, arable land, Saudi Arabia's agricultural potential will be immeasurable and may even create achievements that are more brilliant than any glorious period in history. Not only that, many countries in the world are currently facing severe challenges of desertification. If China's water and fertilizer management and cultivation technology designed specifically for desert areas can be widely promoted, it will greatly alleviate the global food shortage problem, while promoting the population carrying capacity of areas surrounding the desert and promoting the overall development of the regional economy and society. To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.